All right, so welcome back. Restaurant's doing good?
Restaurant is packed nonstop. This is it. This is the week.
In fact, you said you're down here. I can't believe you're down here. This is the busiest day of the year for you.
It is, for catering.
700 people you're catering
just
for
in the morning. Before 11 o'clock. So the guys, we've been there since 6:30, and they were there till last night till about 12:30. So.
Wow.
We're very well rewarded for it. The guys are really taking care of it. I really do. I have a great crew. They've been so long.
You do have a, and it's like family when you eat.
Let's get to the cooking.
What are we making?
Well, first of all, I love cannolis. You know that. I always go to make cannolis.
I see it all over Instagram.
It's Christmas time, so I'm thinking peppermint mocha.
Oh,
so
yes.
I have a little bit of chocolate, and this is something you could do at home with the kids, you know,
all right,
for the holidays.
What is this first in the bowl there?
This is ricotta. Now, here's the secret to this ricotta. Uh-huh. Buy your ricotta and drain it, because not everybody comes to Jasper's and buys their ricotta. And our
ricotta,
you can buy it, sure you can. And what you
do, buy anything
once you buy, yeah, come on, I'll say anything.
Just ask them.
They know people. That's what
but when you buy the ricotta, it's too wet in the grocery stores.
Yeah.
So you need to strain it. Mama always, or Nana also.
Like a cheesecloth?
Exactly. Put it in a cheesecloth over the sink and let it drain, and then whip it on a mix master for at least 15 minutes.
Whip it good.
And you'll get this right here, and it becomes very, very fluffy and all that. So.
And then you put chocolate sauce in there?
Chocolate. And of course, a little bit of powdered sugar. You have to have the powdered sugar. You don't want to put regular sugar. And here's the thing that people don't realize. Powdered sugar, the second ingredient in powdered sugar, people don't know, it's a thickening agent.
Is it?
So it's, yeah, it's cornstarch in there.
Oh, I didn't know that.
So when you actually start working with it, it helps thicken. So this may be a little watery still.
But it'll
Some peppermint. Come on, just get the peppermints and chop. You don't have to have anything fancy.
And then you have the kids can have fun with that.
And you can take out your aggression.
That's what I'm doing this morning. So
I heard Leslie in the kitchen the other night. I had gone to sleep, and she was banging on us. Like, what is she doing in there? She was crushing up M&M's or something.
Yeah, exactly. A little touch of vanilla. I love vanilla. This is local vein vanilla. And then some chocolate chips. Now, come on. Now, let the kids become creative. Maybe you want some nuts, and some people can't have them with the nut allergies. So if you want to put some pistachios or pecans or walnuts, that's up to you. And all you do is just mix this together. But really decorating the shells, and buy your shells. I mean, shells are they're a little harder to make.
Now, what are shells made out of?
So very, very simple. When I was in Italy last year, actually in Sicily, I was on the cannoli trail looking for the greatest shells.
That, yeah.
And I found out that the number one thing you need to do is have something with a little bit of vinegar in it or red wine. So your basic dough, you're going to have flour, of course.
Right.
You're going to have Crisco, you know, lard.
Yeah.
Lard is the best, I'm sorry to say.
Lard's actually better for you.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Come on. Now, people are finally realizing that. A little bit of sugar and then vinegar. And when you put the vinegar or wine in it, what happens, look at this. You see all these little holes?
When
happens, all these little holes right here, they become, it splatters when you drop it into the oil. And that's what you want.
All right, let's get stuffing there, Jasper.
Come on.
We got
so
one
this
minute
is so,
left.
This is so easy. Well, we need to talk about Nana's cookies too.
Yes.
I brought. So if you look at Nana's cookies, those are so simple to make, easy ingredients. Now, I'm not lying to you. I've been making these since I was a little boy, especially cannolis too, but the cookies are so simple. Flour, butter, some nuts, of course. You gotta have some nuts in there. And a little bit of powdered sugar.
And there they are right down there.
And that's there is to it, yes. And you bake them and then you roll them in powdered sugar. They are so delicious. I'm leaving these all for
now,
you guys.
Now, are those the same as the Italian wedding cookies?
Well, you know what? Here's the thing. In Kansas City or in the Midwest, we say biscotti.
Biscotti
means twice cooked. So that's what we call them, biscotti. But we don't twice cook. These are called Russian tea cookies. Like you'll have Mexican wedding cookies, same thing. They're all the same. It's a basic sugar dough. What you could put nuts in. You could really do anything, but you roll them in that powdered sugar. I'm teasing you with this right here. I'm sorry.
We couldn't rename them Russian collusion cookies.
Well, I didn't want to say because I know we would go there.
Jasper's is located off 103rd Street. It's right near State Line. You can call, make your reservation, do it online at jasperskc.com. Jasper, thank you so much.